Hi, everyone. My name is Ke Wen. I'm from the PyTorch distributed team at Meta. At PyTorch Conference 2022, I'm going to present PiPPy, Automated Pipeline Parallelism for PyTorch. This work is done together with Pavel Balwick. In this talk, I'm going to go through what PiPPy is, why we use pipeline parallel, and I'm going to dive into the techniques details of PiPPy. And last, I will show a case using PiPPy as an example. PiPPy stands for Automated Pipeline Parallelism for PyTorch. It is a library that automatically transforms a model into a pipeline. Then it can help the user distribute the pipeline stages to multiple devices or multiple hosts and weave the connection between stages for the user such that the user do not need to do them manually. At last, it can orchestrate micro batches through the pipeline in an overlapped version to achieve parallelism. Why do we need pipeline parallel? First, it is essential to the training of super large models, including large language models, which cannot fit into a single GPU. Second, it can help high communication latency. For example, while micro batch one is going through the communication phase, micro batch two can start running on the device with computation, hence increasing the device utility. Now let's look at how PiPPy do all the job. First, let's look at how it can transform a model. It provides an API called from tracing. It accepts a model from the user, and then we transform the model into a graph representation, where each node in the graph is an operation that corresponds to the original model. Then, either with user annotated split points or by PiPPy's own auto analysis, PiPPy can cut the graph into stages. For example, such auto analysis may include splitting the graph into stages of roughly equal sizes. At last, PiPPy can regenerate a model from the graph representation. The regenerated model is called a graph module, where each submodule corresponds to a split stage. And the submodule will contain operations from the original user model. Now that we have a pipeline, we need to think about how we drive the input through the pipeline. And that's done by a class of PiPPy called pipeline driver. Data comes in the form of micro batches. Together with the multiple stages, we have a 2D matrix. And the pipeline driver schedules tasks through this 2D matrix in a wavefront-based manner. For example, we can first push micro batch 0 to stage 0, and then micro batch 1 to stage 0. After that, micro batch 0 might already finish. Then we can continue to push it through stage 1, so on and so forth. By going through the matrix in a diagonal way, we make sure the tasks that are available to run are always scheduled first. PiPPy provides a set of scheduling algorithms, including filtering, one forward, one backward, and interleaved one forward, one backward. Now let's look at an example. Here, we use PiPPy for T5. T5 is a language model that can perform a set of tasks like translation, text summary, and question answering. On the left-hand side, we show that PiPPy can split the T5 model in 8 stages, each with roughly same size in terms of parameters. And then we coupled PiPPy with DDP by creating multiple pipelines and connect the corresponding stage of each pipeline into a DDP ring. With this, we can train the model in a 2D parallel fashion. 3D parallel, further including tensor parallel, is also under development. We run the training on GCP. We scale the number of GPUs from 32 to 128 by increasing the DDP size, meaning increasing the number of pipelines. And we can see that with a 4x increase in GPUs, we achieved 3x speedup in the training speed. On the right-hand side is a visualization of one of the pipelines. We can see a roughly V shape from the visualization, which is the expected behavior of a pipeline in training. And we can also see that the backward stage of the pipeline is well packed. To summarize, a user can use PiPPy in four simple steps. First, the user can create a model as usual, as if it's on a single process. Then you can create a pipeline by splitting the model using PiPPy's from tracing API. Next, you can create a driver to drive the pipeline, and what the driver returns will be already a distributed model. And last, you can pass the distributed model with input as if you're doing a single process training. That's all for my talk. Please come visit us at github.com/pytorch/tao. Thank you.